Neither Tibaldi nor any other singer at the time could match Callas' repertory, which ranged from Mozart and Beethoven to Wagner and Puccini, roles ranging from a coloratura to a dramatic soprano.
Up to the point that these people will not be singing my same operas, will not be doing what I do. So you see, rivals I have not.
Even Renata Tibaldi agrees.
I don't know why they put this kind of rivality, because the voice was very different. She was really something and unusual.
Tibaldi thought the supposed Callas-Tibaldi rivalry had its benefits.
And was very good in the end for both of us, because the publicity was so big. And they created a very big interest about me and Maria. I remember that I was very young artist too, and I stayed near to the radio every time that I know that was something in the radio by Maria, because the most fantastic thing was when the possibility for her to sing the soprano coloratura with this big voice. And this was really something very special.
Tibaldi's Chicago performances were conducted by Callas' mentor, Tullio Serafin. Callas sang Madama Butterfly for her first and only time on stage.
We had the three performances scheduled, but the demand for tickets was such that we persuaded Maria to do a fourth performance. And I remember it was sold out like in half an hour, just lines around the building at Wacker Drive there in Chicago. Maria had a contract from her young days with a certain Mr. Bagarozzi. He was after her for money, and I think the theater had assured her that we would try to protect her from this type of invasion. I went to the theater that night. Kelly and Fox came to my dressing room and told me that Maria was going to be served with papers. I felt a loyalty to Maria. I knew what this meant to her, and I had the tremendous dilemma whether to tell her, and I don't know if I was wise or not, but I did not tell her.